Hi, and welcome to another video on my channel. Today it's going to be in English, and to dive straight into it, it's going to be a new video series called 5-Minute Book Reviews. Today we'll be speaking about Haruyana Gihara's new novel, To Paradise, that just recently came out in January 2022. As usual with my videos, you can click down there to have the video translated in German or in Russian. Ihr könnt die Untertitel einschalten, um das Video auch auf Deutsch mitzuverfolgen. И вы также можете включить русские субтитры, чтобы иметь перевод с английского. This will be short, quick, precise, to the point, so if you're still undecided whether on you should read or shouldn't read the book, this is the one for you. I'll be rating the book on 5 different criteria and we'll go straight through them. But before we get to that, let's get to the very first thing, and that will be the plot in one sentence. So this is a book that is set in 3 eras, 1893, 1993, and 2093. The stories between those eras, they are linked together, and there is a common thing among them. They take place in New York, the actual New York, or an alternative place of it. Speaking about the pace of the novel, I would say that it's mid-paced. The first part is quite slow and it takes a while to get into it. It was 100 pages for me, but the rest of them are medium-paced, I would say. For the first evaluation criteria, over here, I'm going to ignore the cliche of not judging a book by its cover, and I am going to evaluate this book's cover. I'm not necessarily a fan of it. If it was in the bookshop, I probably wouldn't have picked it up if I didn't know the author, but at least it has a meaning behind it. Unfortunately, the font of To Paradise, it somehow reminds me of the font of the series, and just like that. But the painting, at least it has meaning behind it. It really ties the story together. You will find out when you read it. And it's the painting called Yokepa by the artist Hubert Voss. To speak about the second criteria, the style. So since it takes place in those 3 time periods, each of the time periods has a corresponding style to it, which are very different. I was very surprised how old-fashioned the first part was, but then understood what its thing was when reading on. It's the style that those of you who have already read Yanagihara's work will be something that you recognize. So it's very descriptive, it's very visual. You feel right inside the scene, you can picture everything, you can see the characters in front of you. I would say that it is emotional, but for those who have read A Little Life, the emotional strings that it pulls are much subtler. It did have different emotional touch points for me, but it wasn't devastatingly sad. It just like made you think about a lot of different topics. On to the third point, which will be evaluating the characters. I had a little notebook with me where I was noting down things while I was reading, and I had to draw out multiple character plans because at times it was just so confusing. There were tons of different ones introduced and to understand who was who. But then once you got into that, you felt really attached to the characters. They're crafted in a very intricate way. You can really see and understand them, and you don't want that part of the book to end which they're situated in. And this is not a spoiler, but the same names keep popping up in each of the 3 stories, and it's kind of up to you, the reader, to figure out how you're linked. And at least at the end, you get a little hint why the story was written that way. On to the 4th point in my evaluation, and those are the themes that are spoken about in the book. There are so many of them. As I mentioned in the beginning, depending on the different era where the story takes place, there are different themes that are discussed and brought up. It goes from discussions on race and gender, the inequalities linked to that, youth and aging, sickness and health. One of the parts speaking about the 1980s AIDS crisis. It goes on to family relations, parenthood, family ties and bonds and obligations, and most importantly, the future. This is what one half of the book is about, 2093, how we imagine this future. And obviously, even though the author started writing the book in 2017, she was influenced by what was going on in the world. So she writes about the possible future of pandemics, about cooling suits, what we would do linked to the global climate change crisis, to the crisis of feeding all the human beings on Earth. So it really goes into kind of like this very, very broad area of subjects. onto the fifth evaluation criteria, which will be the details of what exactly I liked or didn't like about the book. One thing I loved was the style that it was written in. It was very well crafted. It was a pleasure to read sentence to sentence. I really appreciated how gripping the book was, so the approximately 700 pages I just read in no time. I finished it in 2 weeks, and I don't remember when was the last time that I read a book that thick and that quickly. So you can see I've been highlighting passage after passage. There were a lot of things that really spoke to me that made me think of personal links to the story, so that was really great. And to sum it all up, this was a story that was challenging to the reader, so you have to stay on top of all the details in the story to find out how they're linked to each other. But this made me want to reread this book another time, and I think this is a great sign of good writing and keeping the reader interested. I am for sure going to read the author's first book, The People in the Trees, which I wasn't tempted to do before after A Little Life because I was afraid of ruining the A Little Life phenomenon of loving that book so much. Let me know in the comments whether you maybe read any of the author's books, whether you like them or not. Maybe if you read A Little Life, or if you did yourself read The People in the Trees. And then finally, the parts that I didn't like that much. It was partly the style as well, because in the first part, it is so old-fashioned and stiff that it made me feel like it was written about a Jane Austen kind of love story based in the past with an LGBTQ plus twist to it. So one kind of like reduction from the rating on that. And the pacing of the story seemed a bit off towards the last part. So the third story, the very end, how it finishes, I feel like it was a bit too rushed and it was a bit less believable than the rest, feeling like the author tried to wrap it up quicker than necessary. So this for me would result in the final rating of 4 out of 5 stars, and I really hesitated between 4 or 5 out of 5 stars, so this is really high on my list of books that I read. I do count it within my all-time favorite books to read though. That was it for my evaluation, and to wrap this all up, I would say that this book would be interesting to those people who like well-crafted characters that take over more space than the plot line. So deep diving into the psychology of every character. For those who love a very intricate and crafted kind of imaginative style, those who like intertwining storylines, trying to find how the individual stories are linked among each other, and for those who have got some time on their hands, because this is quite something, the length of this book. I would suggest to read it in longer sittings, which are close to each other, so that you keep the things in your memory that make you understand the whole book better. Thank you so much for coming by my channel, for watching this video. I hope you liked this one. Let me know whether you read To Paradise yourself, whether you agree with my rating on it, or if you perceived some things differently. And if you're curious to have any other of these type of 5-minute reviews on books, let me know as well. And maybe there are some that I've already read or that I will be looking forward to reading and maybe reviewing it on here. Thank you so much, and see you in the next video. Bye!